Hey, what's up, guys? My name is Derek. I'm with my partner, Dane.
What's up, guys?
And this is going to be the first installment in a long overdue D&D Performance Interior vlog series. My mama calls, see you on TV. Sunset shit done changed. Ever since we was on, I dreamed it all. Ever since I was young, they said I wouldn't be nothing. Now they always say congratulations. Worked so hard, forgot how to vacation. So the purpose of these vlogs are so we can give you guys a more comprehensive, detailed view at what we do here at D&D. We're going to be doing installation videos because we get a lot of emails asking us how to install certain products of
stuff
ours.
Like quick releases, hubs, wheels.
We'll also be documenting the progress we're making on our Project S13. We'll be showing you guys prototypes as well, stuff that's not in production just yet.
Stuff that we're working on, looking for your feedback, if we should make some changes before we put it into production.
We really need your feedback because at the end of the day, if you guys don't think it's cool, it's not worth making for us. But before we get too in-depth on everything, we should probably introduce ourselves.
Yeah,
my name's Derek, this is Dane. We actually met in high school about 10, 12
years ago. Like when we first met, I had a 240, Derek had a SC300. Over the years, we've had this might be like our 8th 240 we've had. So we're pretty familiar with them. But then we kind of realized after owning that many 240s, we kind of like Toyota's better. So I ended up getting a GS300 drift car and Derek got a Super Mark III drift car.
Both of them have 2Js. We'll be showing you our personal cars too. We have a lot of things that we want to show you guys. So today wasn't super busy at the office, which gives us a little bit of time to work on the S13, which is nice. Dane's hidden here working on the seats, and he's also working on the rear seats. Fun fact, we actually have S14 rear seats in our S13. I don't think anyone really does that, but Dane is super mechanically inclined and he is making this work somehow. Just to fill you guys in on what we were doing before our first vlog, we actually just got this car back from paint. The color is like a dark purple with a lot of flake in it. It's actually kind of like the signature color for D&D. And we also have been working on aero and cosmetics. This is a Rocket Bunny diffuser that's on here. I really like the look of it. We also opted to go with a fine line tuning drag wing. It mounts pretty much flush to the rear trunk. I'm kind of a fan of this look more so than like the big GT wings. This is the motor. And these VH45s are out of Q45s, which is the big four-door Nissan sedan. So that's the finished product. We have a pair of our Seca seats in our S13. It looks really good with the red stitching. It really fits the theme. And then for those of you that are wondering, S14 seats do fit in an S13. I mean, depending on what you think fitting is, but we think it looks pretty good. I'm 6'2". I have plenty of headroom, and that's mainly because our second seat doesn't have any external cushioning. There's no cushions that remove and come off of the seat itself. It's all padded down to the fiberglass, and you get probably an inch of headroom, even more so than like the Bride Lomax seats. So it's definitely one of the lowest seating positions that you'll be able to get.
And on top of that, we also removed the sliders too, just because Derek and I are going to be sharing the car. So we're pretty close in height. I'm like 5'11", you're
6'2".
Yeah, so with us sharing it, it helps more solid seating position too.
Like we've said before, we've had a bunch of 240s and usually I'm driving them like hunched over or like on my head sideways when I have a helmet on, but we don't have any issues with these. So that's a really good thing for you guys to know.
So I also wanted to show you guys this week some of the new Samurai shifters we got in stock. These are our two new colors. This one's platinum and this one is gold. Still one piece brass like before. They're just plated a different color. Especially excited for this one. This is a FRS handbrake replacement. We brought in the Samurai shifter hydros, or the hydros with the Samurai handle, but a lot of you guys were asking for something to replace your stock handbrake, especially the FRS BRZ guys. So this was a long time coming. We were working on this for a while, but this just goes over your stock handbrake handle, and then it comes with a spring-loaded button and it actuates it from the inside. I don't know if you can see that, but that's something we are really excited to test, and once we're sure that it works perfectly fine, we'll get that on the website as well for you.
So we're in the office now. It got a little too hot in the warehouse, but we want to thank you guys for watching the first vlog. We want to shout out also Hayden Tansley, the winner of our D&D second seat giveaway. Just a cool kid. He came in locally to pick it up because he's from SoCal too. He really seemed like he's into cars. He has a Turbo Miata himself, so we're glad it went to someone like that.
Yeah, we really love to do more giveaways like that. We have a bunch of steering wheels, shift knobs, and quirk releases. Maybe if we can do something like this once a month or once every other month, that'd be pretty cool.
We're gonna keep doing these vlogs too. We have a lot more cool stuff coming. In the next episode, we'll probably finish up the S13. We'll take it drifting. We have a personal drift event that we're going to also with our personal cars out on the balcony.
It's gonna be a good time though. Lots of tandems. Hopefully they let us do ride-alongs, give some buddies a ride.
So yeah, stay tuned. The next episode, we'll do more instructional stuff too. Depends on what you guys want. Just let us know in the comments. Like and subscribe, follow us on Facebook, and check us out on Instagram as well. See you guys.
Peace.